has gone astray. Oh, I'm leaving town and I ain't coming back again.
Hi, I'm Meg from Professional Music Technology, and in this video we will be diving into one of my favourite areas of music, as we will be taking a look at a range of instruments commonly used by country, folk and bluegrass players. As I do play in folk and country bands myself, I have been very much looking forward to diving into this topic. In this video, we are going to take a look at five key folk and roots instruments that you're likely to come across if you are playing in these genres. So that will include banjo, mandolin, resonator, lapsteel, and of course, acoustic guitar. I'm going to be explaining the differences between each of them, running through some of the key features, and then recommending a few models for each instrument that you can try out at your local professional music technology. First up, let's take a look at the acoustic guitar and some of the key features to look for when selecting a guitar for your folk or bluegrass setup. As it has its roots in traditional music, bluegrass and country guitarists generally tend to play acoustic over electric. Country genres are well known for their twangy tones, and often smaller bodied Parlour or OM style guitars are well suited to this sound. A great example being this Gretsch Jim Dandy Parlour size acoustic. A short scale guitar with a smaller body, giving it a real twangy and bright tone. This is suited nicely to the finger picking patterns used commonly across these genres. In contrast to that, a Dreadnought acoustic is also a very popular choice for country and bluegrass musicians to reach for. The early Martin D18s and D28s would have been flagship guitars when they were first designed for the early bluegrass and country musicians. The loud and full-bodied sound meant the acoustic guitar was able to project over the other loud acoustic instruments such as a banjo or a resonator, particularly in an unplugged setting, something that is still very common in country and bluegrass performances. This Yamaha LLTA is an excellent example of a rich and full-bodied acoustic that would be a great choice for this genre. The spruce top combined with the rosewood on the back and sides gives an excellent bass response, allowing for that rich and punchy sounding acoustic. Next up, let's mention the lapsteel. So lapsteels were used in a variety of roots genres as they grew in popularity, including folk, jazz, gospel, but most particularly country subgenres, honky-tonk, western swing and bluegrass. So let's take a look at this excellent Epiphone Electar 1939 electric lapsteel guitar, a reissue of the original Hawaiian lapsteels. Whilst I might not be the best slide player, as we've seen in previous videos, the unique sounds made from these instruments are definitely one of my favourite things about the genres. Running over the specs quickly, this lapsteel has a one-piece mahogany neck and body. It's got one 500B blade humbucker pickup, a plexiglass fingerboard, and all finished in a sleek ebony finish with authentic 1930s style Art Deco inlays and details. A great feature with these modern day lapsteels is they come fitted with electronics, meaning there will never be the issue of not being heard over the rest of the band.
Thank you.
From the same family as the Lapsteel, next up we'll take a quick look at the Resonator, or Dobro as they are often called. Traditionally, bluegrass players use square-neck Dobro-style instruments played as a steel guitar. So these were first introduced into the bluegrass genres in around the 1950s, and these players tend to play the resonators in open G tuning. So that would be either D, G, D, G, B, D, or you can play it in G, B, D, G, B, D, using a syncopated three-finger picking style. It's common to get resonators with either wooden bodies or a metal body, but we're going to quickly take a look at this Gretsch G9201 resonator. So this guitar has a bell brass body with an amplisonic biscuit bridge cone, which has been spun from 99% pure aluminium. The resulting sound is that classic sharp tone of a single cone resonator, and that cone essentially acts like a giant megaphone projecting the sound out towards the audience, giving you lots of extra volume. The neck tends to join at the 12th fret on these style guitars, and on this guitar it features a maple neck with a padauk fretboard. Paired with the authentic 1930s style Gretsch marking on the headstock, this is a great option for any country or bluegrass players looking for that authentic feel, look, and sound. So, moving on, the fourth instrument I'll be mentioning is the mandolin. Mandolin has been a core instrument in bluegrass music right from the beginning. The traditional choice for bluegrass musicians when choosing a mandolin has commonly been the more modern flatback style with the F cuts, as opposed to the original bowl-backed mandolins of the early folk days. We'll be looking at this Epiphone MM30S mandolin as an example. An interesting fact, Epiphone began in their early days as a family-owned mandolin manufacturing shop, so this model is a nod to their roots. Taking a quick look at the specs, it has a spruce top with mahogany back and sides. It has a 14-inch scale length with an okome neck and features a snakehead style vintage headstock. Bound tortoiseshell pickguard, high-quality Epiphone deluxe vintage tuners, plus classy gold hardware. Overall, these are a great value and great sounding mandolin, perfect for a country or bluegrass setup. Tuned to G, D, A, and E, with each pair of strings tuned in unison, much like a 12-string guitar, the bright and twangy tone of these 8-stringed instruments is a perfect fit for the trademark bluegrass and country sound. Much smaller instruments with that 14-inch scale length and smaller frets means they lend themselves nicely to a picking staccato style of playing, although you can still play chords on mandolins too. An instrument that could not be missed off this list. Instrument in this lineup is, of course, the banjo, an instrument famous for its use in country, bluegrass, and folk genres. Banjos are available in 4- and 5-string models, are commonly tuned to open G, and are usually played with metal fingerpicks, which helps to give them that distinctive banjo sound. Whilst you can get a few main designs and sizes of banjo, the open back, the closed back and the tenor banjo, it's the closed back one which tends to be the most popular choice for those bluegrass and country bands. The closed back design, often called the Resonator, is what makes these a desirable choice. The closed back design acts like a speaker for the sound, and not all banjos have them. What the Resonator is doing is reflecting the tone of the banjo out towards your audience, thus making the banjo louder and brighter. Bluegrass banjoists use a Resonator so they can cut acoustically through the mix of the other instruments in the band or at a jam. This will also allow them to be heard when they take a solo. Taking a look at is this Tanglewood TW18MS. So running over the specs quickly, this is a 5-string banjo with a maple Resonator back and maple sides, a Remo ivory head and a Techwood fingerboard. Maple is a common wood used on banjos as it's very hard and dense, giving it a very bright tone, ideal for bluegrass players. It also features a maple bridge with ebony tip and high quality tuners on the unique looking Tanglewood headstock. The bright yet full tone and exceptional volume from this banjo make it a great pick for bluegrass or country. That was a quick look at some of the best instruments for folk, country and bluegrass music. Of course, there are a couple of other instruments that deserve an honorary mention, including the fiddle and the upright double bass, but I will save you the pain today of hearing me attempt to play both of those terribly. I'd also like to give a big thank you to Matt Harrison from Hometown Show for coming in and playing some of those instruments that I'm not very well versed in. If you want to check out his music, then head to the description below. If you do want to find out any more about any of the products we've looked at today, head to pmtonline.co.uk or you can pop into your local PMT store and have a chat with one of our acoustic experts. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like and subscribe to the channel. Head over to our socials at PMT House of Rock and give us a follow, and I will see you in the next video.